Welcome to this brief guide on how to transcribe audio using OneNote. If you've ever needed to transcribe a piece of audio into typed text, you'll know that it can be time-consuming and cumbersome. But today I'm going to show you a feature in OneNote to make that easier than ever before. Here you can see I'm inside my OneNote client, and I've got a page open, and I've called it Transcribed Audio. In order to transcribe a piece of audio, I simply head to the Home tab in my ribbon and head all the way to the right-hand side where I'll see the option for Transcribe. For those of you that utilize the Classic ribbon, I'll show that here as well. In the Classic ribbon, it's also at the right-hand side of the Home row. Now we'll jump back over to the Simplified ribbon, and I'm going to select the option to Transcribe. Clicking on this will open up a sidebar where I can then see my options for transcription. Here, the first thing you'll notice is that it's linked to the page. By default, this is automatically the page that I was currently on, as you can tell by the title, which matches the title that I have already created for my OneNote page. Jumping back over to the sidebar, you'll notice that I get to choose the language. By default, it's the language of my Office installation, but as you can see, you've got a large selection of languages that you can choose from in the drop-down menu. I'll leave that as English Australia for this. Then we have two options, the first of which is to upload audio if we have an audio recording already, or we can use Start Recording and record using our system's microphone. I'm going to upload audio as I already have a recording that I recorded using my mobile phone earlier. Selecting Upload Audio will open up File Explorer and allow you to select your audio file. In this case, I'm using an M4A file, but obviously you can also use MP3 or WAV files, etc. Selecting the file will automatically upload it to OneDrive, as that is where your OneNote notebook is held as well, and then you'll begin that process of transcription. Depending on how long the audio file is, this transcription process can take a few moments. Now that it's done, I have a player right here at the top with a few different options, including the ability to change the playback speed if I wish to speed it up, which in this case I can select 1.5 speed, and I can select play. Now the thing that you'll note at the bottom here is that it currently has speaker one and it's got live transcription showing me exactly what's happening with timestamps available as well that progress along as the audio recording is moved. So if I was to use the playback bar at the top here and skip forward, the transcription will skip forward to match where I clicked on as well. Now in this case, it's tagged me as speaker one. If there were multiple speakers, it would show those as individual users as well. Now that I've got my transcription ready, I can select the option that says add to page, and I'll get a few selections that I can choose from, whether or not I want just the text, or whether I want it to have the speakers as well, or with timestamps, or the last option there, which is with speakers and timestamps. I'm just going to insert the text for this instance, and you can see that it's automatically inserted all of the text ready for me to be able to make any quick changes to if I wish. I've also got hyperlinks, which will take me to the audio file where it exists in my OneDrive account. And that is how you transcribe audio using OneNote. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.